We all have to commute to work unless you work at home, but how many people calculated the cost of the commute to work? A 1 hour commute requires at least 40% more income than the same job with no commute to justify the commute. When I read these numbers, it was quite confronting. Would it be better to take a job that, for example, pays 20% less, but you can work from home, or the same job, but you have to commute 1 hour? How much thought have you put into where you live compared to where you work? Perhaps you clicked on this because you were considering a new job or moving where you live. Let's look at the factors behind this and why I say a 1 hour difference in commute requires a 40% income increase to cover it. How much does it cost to commute further to work, and the value of working from home? One of the often overlooked aspects of what job to take is the location of where you live. There are two sides to this problem. If you have a fixed address, for example, you have a mortgage and selling your house wouldn't work, then it would probably be optimal to find a job nearby. On the other side, if you're earning a decent wage, it might be optimal to move closer even if it's more expensive. With the standard 40-hour work week, a 1 hour commute, which is quite common these days, some people travel even much further. However, a 1 hour commute is 2 hours every day. With 5 days in a week, that adds up to 10 hours a week. 10 hours is 1/4 or 25% of 40 hours. However, when you earn more, you have to pay more taxes. And the government doesn't factor in that it might cost you more to earn more, either in terms of time or in terms of cost. Then you need to also factor in the cost of travel. If you drive, then there are petrol costs, or even in an electric vehicle, there is a general cost of using the car, including more factors of repair and other factors. If you catch public transport, in most cases, further travel will be more expensive tickets. The specific amount depends on your tax rates, how far you travel, whether you use a car or public transport, and those cost implications. But you won't be getting any change out of 40%, and you might even find it works out to be even more. I've lived 1 hour away from work, and I've lived within walking distance of work, and I can tell you that the same workday with the 1 hour commute is significantly more tiring than the same workday without it. If you're considering a new job that is an hour away from your home, or if you were even considering moving, this travel time is an important factor to consider. One caveat that I would add to all this, though, is that if you can walk or even run or even ride a bike to work, it turns a commute into a productive use of the time, which also cuts down on the impact of the commute. But riding public transport or driving through busy traffic feels more like work. Is it the company's fault that you have to travel this far? No. And I'm not saying that they should expect to pay you more, unless they make you move or they move the office an hour away. However, from your perspective, it does cost you more to complete the job. If you look at your job as an exchange between your services and your workplace's money, then the cost of what you provide goes up, and as you can see, it's a lot more than most people think. For some people, driving is their whole job, so even if it's not your job, it does feel like work, and when most people commute to work in busy traffic, it's also generally a more stressful version of driving. If you work in a job where you can earn more if you do more work or get more results, such as commissions or bonuses, then it might be instead of commuting 1 hour each way, you work 2 extra hours and you earn much more in commissions, for example. A lot changed in 2020, and one of the biggest changes to the workplace has been the adaptation of work from home. The amount of extra time you have in your day when you work from home is quite eye-opening. There are definitely downsides to working from home too, but it's a different topic which I'll cover in detail at another time. However, in terms of the lack of commuting benefits, having extra time in your day gives you more time to do whatever it is that you enjoy. And perhaps it is that you love your job and you want to do more to earn more. That allows you to work the time that you would have spent commuting and therefore get more done, but still be at home, finish your day at the same time. Obviously, this isn't applicable to every job. However, every job that you have a workplace that you have to go to has its positives and negatives as to where you can live. This also puts into perspective how much are you saving to buy a cheaper house that is further away from work. Perhaps you have to because it's all you can afford on your budget. But quite often the choice is more between a smaller place closer to work or a larger place further from work. Now, having extra space is great, but what is it truly costing you? It may be worth it for you, but at least be aware and think it through. I've spoken to people who say lots of people commute 1 hour, so what's the big deal? And whilst that's true, it's still costing you that time. And many people would take a job that pays 10% more, even though it was further away because of this thinking. However, could you earn 10% more where you currently work if you put an extra 30 minutes in a day, for example? You might be able to use your commute time to be productive and make phone calls in the car, for example, in which case the commute might not be as different. Whatever your current situation, I encourage you to take a moment and think about your work, your current location, and your commute time and how it impacts when you work out how many hours you are spending, and would it be better to perhaps move locations or ask your work for a different working scenario. This is just food for thought. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please chuck me a like and subscribe to see more thought-provoking videos like this. As always, good luck.